Graham Wagg took 5 wickets, but Worcestershire battled themselves back into the game on day 3 against Glamorgan. Worcestershire resumed on 150 for 2, a slender lead of 33, and lost a wicket with just one run added, fell nicked off against Wagg for 65 to one sliding across him. The next over brought another wicket, Cola Canmore caught by Wallace off Hogan for a third ball duck. Clark and Whiteley came together to stop the morning rot, putting on 104 for the 5th wicket, with Clark dominating the scoring between the pair. Clark passed his 50 from 113 balls, and he and Whiteley continued to ensure the Morgan would have to chase a substantial target in the 4th innings of this match. Clark and Whiteley took Worcestershire through the early afternoon, and the standard passed 3 figures when it was ended, Clark caught by Carey off Wagg, just 2 runs short of a century. Carey had 2 wickets in 2 balls when Whiteley was caught behind off Wagg for 37. Cox joined Leach, and the pair added 23 to the Worcestershire lead before they were separated. Cox legged before to Macheda for 9. Leach and Barnard came together and put on 29 for the 8th wicket. Just before tea, Barnard was legged before to Wagg for 16, completing the all-rounder Wagg's 5-fer. Leach and Chantry added a valuable 56 for the 9th wicket. Morgan bowled Chantry for 29, but Leach had excellent support from Morris for the final wicket. Worcestershire were 393 all out when Morris was LBW to Morgan for 11, Leach unbeaten on 65. Worcestershire falling just short of the 400 mark then, a card built around contributions from Fell, Clark and Leach, who all passed 50 but couldn't reach 100, with Clark falling just 2 short of the milestone. Glamorgan needed 277 to win, but Leach bowled a wicket maiden in the first over of the innings, Selman departing caught behind for a 6 ball duck. Rudolph was joined by night watchman Morgan, and the pair saw Glamorgan through to close with no further loss of wickets. Rudolph 7 not out, Morgan unbeaten on 9, Glamorgan 16 for 1 at stumps, needing another 261 runs to win, with 9 wickets remaining.